Well, three Iowans are headed to China for the Olympics.
They certainly are. We're not talking about Sean Johnson here, but Emily Givens is with us now to explain. Who, Emily?
Well, instead we're talking about Corey, Jody, and Jenna, names you don't know now, but maybe you should.
I'm very ready.
Jenna Schrack. Corey Leonard and Jody Sheriff.
I'm nervous and I'm excited, wrapped into one.
Are the only three Iowans on Team USA headed to the Special Olympics World Games.
We're going to give them their passport so they can get out of the country.
They're going to a place none of them have ever been.
Hey, baby Kate. Hi, Mom. Oh, that's what I have for you.
What?
Chinese language. Attach this to your credential.
This is the first time I've ever been out of the States.
Jody and Jenna will compete in bowling, though they tracked another female from Iowa on her journey to the Olympics. They never imagined the same could happen to them.
And so now people are kind of keeping tabs on you.
Yeah.
Yeah, it does feel like I'm on the stage and I'm an athlete and I'm going to China, and it feels like an honor.
Corey's already competed in two World Games and knows what it's like to bring home a gold. Coaches say moments like that can turn a life around.
That's what Special Olympics was designed for when Mrs. Shriver founded it back in 1968, was to give people with intellectual disabilities a chance to improve their self-esteem, and show the rest of the world what they were capable of.
That's exactly what Jody, Jenna, and Corey intend to do, starting in Shanghai.
You think us people around here are going to be talking about Jenna Schrack?
Probably. What a great trip.
I hope to do it again.
That's pretty cool.
Come back with the gold.
The team of three is now headed to California, where they will meet up with the rest of Team USA. In all, the U.S. will send about 400 athletes to compete in China. 160 or so countries, they say, will send athletes as well. Steve?
Good luck to Jody, Jenna, and Corey. Nice story. Thank you, Emily.